The catastrophic injuries that cost Eight Bells her life at the 2008 Kentucky Derby highlighted the perils faced by thoroughbred racers. Researchers at Purdue University are developing technology that can detect tiny cracks in bones that precede stress fractures in horses. Biomedical engineering professor Ozan Akas's device measures acoustic emissions.
When these microfractures form, that energy is released as an ultrasound wave. And that ultrasound wave travels within the bulk of the body. And then when it hits the sensors that we placed on the skin, it generates an electrical signal that we can measure.
Purdue veterinarian professor Steve Adams is testing the device on animals at the university's large animal hospital. He foresees the interdisciplinary research saving lives.
This has the potential to pick up these microcracks before they become larger fractures. In other words, they become either stress fractures or even worse, these catastrophic injuries. A lot of those catastrophic fractures of bones occur first as small little fissures, and then they get bigger and bigger, and then they eventually develop to the point where the bones actually catastrophically fail.
Acoustic emission testing has been used to study failures in bridges, turbines, and airplanes. Akas first applied the technology testing the strength of bones under duress in a lab setting. He detected sounds of microfractures well before bone failure.
One day it occurred to me that this is a very benign, non-invasive technology. Why am I trying to understand the dead bone here, which is a useful information, but this can very well be applied to predict the fractures occurring in real life.
Adam says the device could have a huge economic impact in horse racing, a $26 billion industry where only a quarter of the horses that go into training remain strong enough to ever compete for a purse.
Anytime the horse can't race, there's a significant loss of that investment because I have no chance, the owner has no chance of getting back their money, in other words, winning a purse. So there's significant, what we call in the industry, wastage.
Vets currently rely on MRI and nuclear medicine for bone injury diagnosis.
Both of these will detect some of these microcracks and stress fractures, but they are expensive procedures, and they are only available at certain large clinics that deal with a lot of horses. So they're not available at trackside or in the training farms.
Initial tests are focused on isolating emissions from the targeted area from the thousands generated by hooves pounding, joints rubbing, or even tails swishing.
We may be able to use it as a diagnostic tool to look for these horses, to look for problems in these horses that may be a little bit off or lame and have a stress fracture in a pelvis or a back that may not become catastrophic, but certainly affect their performance. So it'll give us a diagnostic tool that we don't currently have.
Akas hopes to soon incorporate wireless technology.
Because when we had all these cables and whatnot, they limit the mobility, and further, they generate noise on their own. If you could get one of those cables and hit them with your finger, it's going to generate an emission.
Akas believes the technology will also help humans. Studies show that up to 10% of some collegiate athletes, such as cross-country runners, suffer stress fractures. Up to 20% of soldiers in some basic training units suffer similar injuries. Akas hopes to conduct his first human testing later this summer with cadets at the U.S. Military Academy at West Point. At Purdue University, I'm Jim Shank.